It has come to this. We've waited, hoped, spent long days and even longer nights in the darkness for this, for light to break through. We've waited for a Christmas unlike any other. Our hopes and fears all this year are met in thee tonight. You don't have to be a pregnant mother or an overwhelmed father, a busy innkeeper or an overlooked shepherd to know how different this night is. And yet, when it arrives, it feels quieter than usual. Most years, Christmas arrives to the soundtrack of hustle and bustle, parties and events, crowds and parades. The thing about the first Christmas is how quiet it was. The true mystery of Christmas is how the cosmic collided with the ordinary. And when we find Christmas to be quieter than usual at the end of the longest year, we get a better sense of Bethlehem. And so we come to this Christmas, one that forces us to look back on what we've lost, the hope that we've held on to at a time and season where no one is fine. And we come to this Christmas that forces us to look up to a God who isn't distant and a Son who would breathe his last 6 feet from thieves. And it's come to this, true Christmas, true peace, because in the most well-produced Christmas stories, all the actors are overshadowed by the lead who doesn't even have a single line, and yet he steals every scene he's in. We've come to this, to Christmas, to a king who's making all things new. We've come to this. We've come to adore him, Christ the Lord.